Excuse me. Excuse me. Can I have my car washed?
Yes, ma'am. Just let me finish this.
Mira, it's a miracle the landlady hasn't come for the rent yet. Yeah, maybe she anticipated our excuse. Well, so much for the act I prepared.
Sir, this is only half of our pay.
I'm sorry, but business has been bad these days.
But that wasn't what we agreed on.
If you're complaining, you can quit. And don't ever come back.
I feel awkward, sis.
Brother, you should learn how to fix your own tie. Especially now that you're working at Mother's Hotel. Give me that. Let me do it.
Hey, hurry up. Mom's waiting for me.
Just a minute.
You aren't practicing on me, are you, sis?
Practicing? What do you mean?
The future. You. And your dream boy.
Oh, don't even start.
Sis, if you really feel like you're falling in love, let yourself fall. You know what? Don't be afraid where you fall. I'm sure someone will catch you. Who knows? Your prince might just be waiting to catch you in his arms.
Is this all, miss?
Yes. Do with you.
What's the problem? Take a look at this. This is Nathaniel's. Tell me what it means.
Aunt. Mother. Mother, I brought you something to eat.
Why did you disobey me? Didn't I tell you not to quit school? What's this?
Mother, I need to work. What we need right now is money to pay for our bills.
What happened to the money I gave you for your enrollment?
I paid the rent before we get thrown out.
You're not allowed to interfere with my decisions.
I had no choice. Mother, do you want us to live on the streets? You're telling me that I should go to school and pretend that everything is okay. Even if we have nothing to eat the next day? Mother, I can't do that. I'm sorry, but I can't.
You're disobeying me. You're not listening to me, Nathaniel.
Please, I'm grown up now. Just give me a chance. I can make my own decisions.
Oh, so you're a grown up now, huh? You don't need me anymore. Is that what you mean?
That is not the point.
But that's what you make me feel, that I'm not needed anymore. Why did you ever ask for me, huh? Tell me!
I didn't mean to. I'll just come back.
You know the money that I borrowed, the one for his enrollment? He didn't use it.
That's why I came here. Because I heard that Nathaniel will not be attending school this year. And Maybe there's something I can do to help.
I see. So this is what you want. Every time we need money, we'll just ask Raphael. You want him to be our breadwinner, is that what you want? Huh? We'll just keep asking him for money.
Man, come on, please, don't take this wrong.
Matt, do you know how I feel? Every time you help me, do you really want to know? I feel humiliated. I feel like I'm no good. I feel like I'm a worthless son.
Nathaniel?
Aunt Venny, why is Mother like that? Why can't she give me a chance to make my own decisions? Everything I'm doing for her.
Your mother's just afraid you might make mistakes.
Aren't we supposed to learn from the mistakes that we make?
Nathaniel, it really depends. If you are prepared to accept your own mistakes and not hard-headed, then it's good for you. But you know, there are just some people who can't easily accept the mistakes that they make.
Like Mother.
Hey, I didn't say that, huh? You did.
You know, everything I do is for my mother. But she doesn't see that. She doesn't realize that she's my priority. Do you know the reason why I'm avoiding Nicole?
I knew it! You like her, don't you?
But I'm holding back. Because of Mother. And because of Raphael.
Now you're having a hard time, right? Isn't it difficult for you? I know you're not used to getting up at this time of the day.
When my class starts at 7, I wake up as early as 4 in the morning.
Yeah.
So where does this go?
Here, thanks.
You know, Aunt Mira, I'm sure you can sell more of these products if you can convince people that your garments are really of good quality, don't you agree? And they should also see you wear the products that you sell, just like this one. See?
Didn't you buy this for me? You wear it?
I happen to like it.
Don't you get rashes? It's just cheap.
Now why would I buy something I wouldn't use? It'll just be a waste of money.
Well, I thought maybe you just wanted to help me and that you'd throw it away.
And Mira, of course not. Why would I throw this? If you want, I can even show this off for you right here.
No.
Let me just get this.
Hey, no, Raphael! You're crazy. You don't have to do that.
There. What is it?
Nothing. I'm just glad because even if Nathaniel and I are not in good terms, you're still here helping me.
Anya, when are you planning to start our export business?
I leave that to you, Terry. Anyway, the company is under your name now. And I don't want Don Lucia to suspect that. I didn't turn over all my assets to him.
All right. I'll take over the business so you can spend time with your mother. You were apart from each other for such a long time. So you can enjoy each other's company.
Really, Terry, you've gone such a long way.
Well, I owe it all to your daughter, Miss Milagros.
Mother, now that we're together again, just let me know if you need anything, and I will make sure to give it all to you.
Raphael? Belle? Judy?
Oh.
Oh, sir. We didn't know you're arriving today. How are you?
I'm okay. Where's Raphael?
Here you go. Thanks for
buying.
You come back.
Get it. Buy one, take
here.
One.
Thank you. Hey,
come
are
on,
you sure
get
you're okay? It's so hot in the dust.
I'm okay. I'm enjoying myself. Selling's fun, especially when you have lots of customers.
Are you getting this? Okay.
Here.
Look at you. Your shirt is drenched with
Thank
sweat.
You.
Wait. Turn around. You're soaked with sweat. Did you bring an extra shirt with you? You'll have to change or you'll catch a cold and your father will get mad at me. Your back's all wet. Buy one, take one! Why didn't you answer? Who was it?
It's my dad.
Oh, Mother, I'm so full. I missed your home-cooked dishes so much. It's so delicious. Mm.
Well, don't worry, dear. When I get the chance, I will cook for you every day.
Really?
Mother, you're the only one I've left. And now that we're together, peacefully once and for all, I will rebuild my dreams for you. I want to buy a house in any place of your choice. And Mother, you don't have to work for anyone anymore. You won't have to worry about work at all. Everything that we've been deprived of before, we'll get it all this time, Mother.
My dear, all I ever dreamed of is to live peacefully. I just want a simple life. And I wish our family can also be together again.
Hi, Penny.
I'll be tomorrow.
Good evening.
Hey, I'll be with you.
Thank
is
you for driving
okay?
me home,
I'll
Rafael.
See you tomorrow. Thanks.
I can't believe you were with me from morning until the time I closed down. I won't keep you long then. You should be home soon. Your father might be looking for you.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
My dear, you know, I know where Mira is staying. If you want, we
No. can... I'm still not ready to see her.
My dear, she's no longer a part of the family I want to have. Let's leave early tomorrow. We'll go shopping and then we can see a movie.
Well, I'm not really up to doing all that.
I'll give you everything you want. I'll buy it for you, like clothes, shoes, jewelry.
Aren't you really going to talk to Nathaniel?
What's the use? We have very different opinions.
But Mira, your son has a point.
But what about me, Vinny?
All right, I know your point. You're just thinking of your son's future. But let me ask you, Mira, can you give him everything right now?
That's what I'm working so hard for.
Mira, you must admit it. It's still not enough.
Maybe if Danielle were here, he would appreciate all my efforts. He'll understand that I'm doing this for him.
and he wouldn't just carelessly disregard all my dreams for him.
Man, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to involve you in our problems.
It's okay. Forget it. I understand. But I just hope you won't stop me from helping you guys. Really, helping you makes me happy.
Just remember, there are limitations. Even in helping.
Just in case we see each other again. I hope you haven't forgotten me. I hope you still remember me.
Raphael! Son! Are you done hibernating? Yeah, and the vacation at the farm had helped me a lot. I was able to contemplate and rest a bit. Now I have straightened out my priorities in life. You, how are you?
I'm okay, Dad.
It's still early. Why don't we go out for a while? Let's have dinner then. Let's go somewhere.
Dad, I'm tired.
Or maybe, if you like, let's visit your Aunt Fiona. Let's see how they are.
They took a vacation in the province.
Okay, I got it. Let's just relax. Let's go to a spa.
No need, Dad.
Raphael. Don't you want to talk to me anymore?
Do you want me to report everything that happened while you were gone?
Of course not. Son, that's not what I meant.
I'm really tired, Dad.
All right. Go and get some rest then.
Mother, look what I brought for you.
Try them on now, please.
Oh, try this one on. It's really beautiful, Miss Milagros. Come on, hurry.
Just a minute. I'll just finish this.
Mother, don't worry about that. I'll call for someone who can do that.
Don't bother, dear. I like what I'm doing anyway. Besides, I really want to busy myself with things to do. Oh, dear. It looks like you girls bought a lot.
Oh my god. Wait, Mother. Here. Look at this. It's perfect on you. You'd be more beautiful. Look at this. Wow!
Lovely. It suits her. I've never really worn anything like this before.
Mother? What's wrong?
Your sister Mira. I wonder if she has nice clothes like this. Ariana. I want to see your sister Mira. My dear. I'm begging you, as a mother. Please forgive your sister, Mira. My dear, 20 years have already passed. 20 long years. I know that Mira once committed a sin against you. But can such a sin really shatter everything, even the bond you both shared as sisters? Have you totally forgotten the love you had for your sister? How would I feel that love, Mother? If all I ever experienced is pain and suffering. Mother! I became a slave because she exchanged me for money. She left me all alone to have her freedom. Don't you understand that? She abandoned me, Mother. I understand you, my dear. But Mira is also my daughter. I hope you'll also understand that. I also long for her as her mother. My dear. Mother, forgive me if I remain cold to my sister Mira. If not only for the medallion, I'd like it better that we live in America and rebuild our new lives there.
Of your application exam are impressive. You almost got it perfect. The only problem is, you're an undergraduate.
I know, sir. That's why I applied for a position that suits my qualifications.
You know, it's such a waste. You're an engineering student, right? But you're applying as a room attendant? Isn't that a little odd?
Well, I'm willing to learn. I learn anything at all, and accept any job you can offer. I really believe that I can carry out my job well, as long as I'm patient, diligent, and professional.
We need a full-time employee.
Well, I stopped schooling so I could help my mother. Besides, I can always go back to school anytime. And as long as you've got determination and a goal, you can finish schooling.
I thought you were good. How come a poor bug like Mira seems so hard for you?
Just give me a little more time so I can win her friendship back.
Why did you quarrel with her?
She's being too noble. It's annoying.
You're the one who needs her. So you better be the patient one.
Patient? Right. I will be patient. For as long as I can. But once I get the medallion, you will no longer be as powerful.
Man! Can you believe it? I passed the first interview at Star Hotel.
Wow.
According to Mr. Lanez, I need another interview, but he says it's just a formality.
Cool, huh?
Great! You're good, man. That means you're as good as hired.
I know. Way to go.
Do you remember exactly what that medallion that you want us to find looks like, Miss Cordero?
I can't remember exactly. But it's round. And it has an inscription that resembles a rainbow. And at one end, there is a wooden chest.
Is it like this, Miss Cordero?
Planning to resign just because you found a new job, you can stop showing up for work starting tomorrow.
Sir, I might start my new job beginning next week, so I'm planning to resign here next week.
No, I'm sorry. There are a lot of people looking for a job. For sure, they're waiting in line to replace you.
If that's the case, sir, I'll resign.
Hey! Haven't you seen the sign? We're already closed!
Excuse me. I know that you're closed, but my car is badly in need of cleaning, and I have an early appointment tomorrow. Can't I please have it washed?
Sorry, miss. Our crew already went home.
Oh, please, sir. I have appointments early tomorrow. It's important.
But no one's here to wash your car.
Please, sir. It's really important.
Sir? I can wash your car for you.
I'm relying on your help, Colonel Belmonte. I hope we can find the medallion as soon as possible.
Don't worry about it, Miss Cordero. We'll do our best to find the medallion. We'll be on our way, ma'am.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, too.
Thank you so much. My child, don't you think the medallion is with Abel? He was the one who buried the woman that he thought was you.
I'm leaving that matter to Colonel Belmonte. If it's really in Abel's hands, then it will be easier to find the medallion. Mother, once we find the medallion, we will leave for America and never come back here again.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm sorry my car's so dirty.
That's okay, ma'am. It's not that hard to clean.
I don't want to get embarrassed by my clients. They're VIPs, you know.
Here you go, ma'am. It's done.
Oh, thank you so much, my savior. Here, take this. Keep the change, okay?
Ma'am, I think this is too much.
So what? Just keep the change.
Thank you, ma'am.
Next time I come back here, I want you to clean my car, okay?
Well, ma'am, I just resigned a while ago.
Huh? But why? Oh, it's getting late. I'll just talk to you some other time. Here's my card. You can call me anytime. Perhaps I can be of help, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you, too. Bye.
Don Lucio. I received reports from my men. Ariana hired a private investigator. It seems she's determined to get that medallion.
I knew I was right in my decision in letting them go, Raul. And now, I have someone to assist me in finding the medallion.
You should put this on. You're getting cold.
Mother? What happened to you?
She's down with the flu. I bet she's overworked and she's been skipping her meals, so she got sick.
And it's only a fever. With just a little rest, I can go back to selling tomorrow.
Oh, give me a break, Mira. You were having convulsions due to high fever.
I can handle this.
Mother, stop that. Look at yourself. You're weak and tired.
What's with you? This is my body. I know what I can and can't handle, and I can't.
Mother, no. From now on, you'll stop selling underwear or whatever in the streets, okay?
Here, eat this.
Brother, how was work?
It's okay. I had a good day.
Really? That's good.
But sis, you haven't dropped by for a visit. Anyway, my office is so nice. But you know, it's still empty.
Really? Don't worry, brother. I'll visit your office first thing tomorrow. I'll bring stuff for decorations. We'll take care of your office.
Really?
Yep.
Man, I know this is embarrassing, but I can't find my friend Presto. I have no one else to turn to. I'm wondering if you can lend me some money. My mother is very ill. I just need to buy her medicine.
Oh man, I'm broke. I have only 10 pesos in my wallet. I'm really sorry. If only I had the money, I'll help you. Hey, there's Rafael. Rafael! Hey, maybe you can help Nathaniel. His mother just got sick. I don't have the money to lend him. Okay, man. See ya.
Tell me, what happened to Aunt Mira?
Oh, you guys are so persistent. I already told you I'm not sick anymore. Oh,
Aunt Mira, your temperature's still high. You still have fever. Here.
Oh, my.
We brought you some fruits and medicine.
Oh, dear. You shouldn't have bothered. This is too embarrassing.
Oh, come on. You don't have to feel that way. I don't mind. What if I take you to the doctor?
Oh, no need. It'll be too much trouble on your part. I'll be fine tomorrow. I can start selling again.
Still so stubborn. Rafael, talk to my mother. Maybe she'll listen to you.
It's good to have you back. It seems you look better now.
Well, sometimes you really have to stop and think about what you really want and what to do with your life. And I'm moving on with my life now, man. I'm not the old Jaime Abelardo Reverente, who used to be trapped in his past for almost 20 years.
You mean, you're ready to forget Ariana? Hey, congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, see you on Monday. Okay.
It's still early. Where are you going?
I'm just gonna go visit my friend's mother. She's sick.
I see. Belle mentioned that to me. You were off and out while I was away. Is that where you always go?
I'm not doing anything wrong, Dad.
Rafael, I'm not saying that you are. I just want to know where you always go.
I just go to their house, Dad. If you don't trust me, come and see for yourself.
Okay, you may go now. But I want you to be home before midnight. Do you understand that?
Mira, what are you doing? You just recovered from fever. Let me do that. Go ahead. You need rest. I'll handle this.
Good morning. Hey, Mira, I brought some fruits for you.
Oh, my, you shouldn't have. There's still some left from the batch you brought here the other day. Now there's more.
We have lots of fruits at home. Nobody eats them anyway, and I don't want them to go to waste. So how are you feeling?
Thank God I'm a little better. The fever's gone. Where have you been?
From school. I had only 2 classes this morning, and that's why I have more free time. Where's Nathaniel?
He has an interview today for a job in a hotel.
What hotel?
Vinny, what's the name of the hotel again?
Let me recall. Star... Is it Star Hotel? Yeah, Star Hotel.
Ma'am, let me carry that for you.
No, I'm fine. I can manage.
Ma'am,
thank
quite
you.
Heavy.
It's okay.
Sorry, Nicole. What are you doing here?
That's supposed to be my line. What are you doing here?
I had an interview. I applied for a job here.
Oh. Well, good luck. Excuse me. Could you take this to my brother's office, please? Excuse me.
Do you know who you just bumped into? That's Miss Nicole, the daughter of the hotel's owner. Excuse me. The world is so small. Can you believe it? The hotel, where I'm gonna work, is owned by Nicole's father.
Well, that's good, isn't it? You'll get the chance to be closer to your sweetheart. So how was the interview?
Wow. This is perfect. My sister is really good at interior design. Hey, what's wrong with you?
Brother, Nathaniel applied for a job here.
Oh my God. Can't you see? Fate is really bringing you two together.
That's just it, brother. Just when we're bent on avoiding each other, it seems that some force is drawing us closer.
Nathaniel, I think it will be best for you to find a job somewhere else.
But why is that?
Because Nicole's family owns the hotel.
Why? What's wrong with that? So what if they own the hotel?
You don't get it, do you, Vinny?
Mother, Aunt Vinny is right. There's nothing wrong with me working at that hotel. I didn't land a job there because of Nicole. And I'll prove to them that I deserve that job. It's nothing personal.
I just learned that Nathaniel applied for a job here. Does he know your family owns a hotel?
I guess not. Otherwise, he wouldn't have applied in the first place.
Are you still mad at him?
I'm so irritated at him, Raphael. I don't know what's going on in his mind. Raphael, Nathaniel is your friend. Did he tell you anything about me?
No, nothing. He hasn't mentioned anything about you.
Let's go.
I can't wait until Mother sees
I'm
this.
I'm sure it'll look good on her.
Mother? 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 Where'd you go?
But Mira, are you sure you're fine?
Yes, I'm well enough, Vinny.
You know you're so stubborn. Just let me know if you feel anything, okay?
I will.
Come on, let's go over there. Let's get a cab. Come on.
Hey, Raphael. You're home just in time. Have you eaten? Come on. Son, do you have a problem? Raphael, I know you have a problem. You can tell me. I'm willing to listen.
I'm okay, Dad.
Raphael.
I said I'm okay, Dad. I'm okay.
Oh,
that Mira lives in a very miserable place. Look at her son. He had to quit school and then they have to pay a lot of debts. She did all kinds of jobs just to get by. I'm telling you, she works even when she's sick. She just can't stop working. That poor woman. Are you Mira's relative?
No, I'm not. Sorry.
Well then, maybe she owes you money. Am I right? Don't count on it. Mira has no money. She won't be able to pay you.
Joey, I don't understand. I'm already making an effort, but he's avoiding me.
I think she took your breakup with Fiona really bad. Rafael is looking for a mother, man. For the longest time, your mind has been set only on one woman. I think it's about time for you, Abel, to finally forget about Diana.
And what? Do I have to find another woman who can't be Rafael's mother? Is that it?
Ma'am? Can I help you? Ma'am!
Do you think Ariana can find the medallion, Don Lucio?
Just keep an eye out for them, Raul. I swear this time, I want to make sure that we won't fail. Too bad. If I got the medallion when I had the chance, I wouldn't have any problems.
Ice cream, everybody! All right, ice cream!
I'll go and get you some ice cream. But as soon as I get back, we're going home, all right?
Yes, big brother.
Yay! Daniel? 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 Daniel!
Where's my ice cream and my toy? Where are we? My brother might be looking for me.
Just wait, my boy. We'll ride this car, okay? Then we'll buy lots and lots of toys just for you.
Okay.
On one condition. You have to give me this medallion.
No way, my mother will get angry.
But I'll exchange it with lots of toys and ice cream, right?
Mother will get angry.
Don't be stubborn, boy. Give me that medallion. Give it to me. Get in the car. Get it. Ah!
Hey!
Tell me what happened.
We encountered some problems, sir.
Who?
I don't know.
How is the child doctor?
He's still under observation and in some shock. Let him rest.
Because of that traumatic experience, Rafael's memory of his past became vague. He can't remember anything about his mother. That's why it was easy for him to accept me as his father. And if Mira could only see her son now, She'd be happy because I raised him well. I hope somehow this will make up for what I did to her when I took her son away.
What is it, Dad?
Nothing. I just wanted to say goodnight.
Good night.
Super.